Today we're going to look at how to perform a Kruskal-Wallis test to test for statistically significant differences between more than two groups. The Kruskal-Wallis test is used instead of ANOVA when your data is not normally distributed. To learn how to do this in R, we're going to be using the ANOVA dataset. So to load our dataset into R, we first need to set our working directory. To do this, we use the setwd function, and then in brackets, we type our working directory in speech marks. Alternatively, you can go to session, set working directory, choose directory, and then just click through to the folder where your dataset is stored. Next, we need to load our data into R. So to do this, we type read.csv as our data is in CSV format, and then in brackets, we type ANOVA underscore data.csv, so the name of our file. And then we assign this to the R object called myData. So if we just load that, and here we have the data set up here. So let's have a look at our data. The data set reports the weight lost by 78 people who have been following one out of three diets. We also have data for gender, height, and age of each of the participants, as well as their weight before undertaking the diets. Today we want to look at whether there is a statistically significant difference in the weight of the participants taking each diet. To do this, we can plot a histogram of the data to check whether this variable is normally distributed. So to plot a histogram, we need to type hist and then in brackets, my data, so our data set, a dollar sign, and then pre.weight, so the variable within the data set that we're interested in. And then we're going to set the title of our plot to weight before. And here we have our histogram. And as you can see, the data is not normally distributed. So therefore, we need to use a Kruskal-Wallis test rather than an ANOVA. So to look at whether there are statistically significant differences between the groups, we need to type Kruskal.test and then in brackets, pre.weight, a tilde sign, and then diet. And then we need to tell R where these variables are stored. So we type data equals my data. And then we store this, the results of this, in a R object called res. And as you can see, it appears here in our R environment. And then to show the results, we just type res, and the results appear here in our console. And then we can see by the high p-value that there is not a statistically significant difference in the weights of the groups before they undertook the diets. And that is how you do a Kruskal-Wallis test in R using RStudio.